Here is part two of a video, grading on a curve, the normal distribution, part two. So grading on a curve means that the teacher determines percent categories of scores on the test in order to give out A's, B's, C's, and D's, and F's. So let's say that there was a test and it came out like this. Here's your test results. The mean was 80. That's the average. The standard deviation or spread of the data was 5, meaning that it's going to be, once you get to 85, it's a little harder to get up there. 90, pretty hard to get up there. 95, extremely hard to get up there. Okay, so on this test, maybe the teacher decides to give the middle 50% C's, the top 10% A's, and the bottom 10% F's, and the B's and D's will be forced at that point. Okay, so normally what the teacher would do is they would just take the total number of scores and count, around the average from there and figure out what the 50% was, and they would do that. But since we have high-powered calculus 2, we're going to do it a better way, a different way. Okay, so we know that if the test scores are normally distributed, then by that previous video, we know that's very special, not only bell-shaped, but have very special area qualities. Then we can find the cutoffs mathematically for each grade. So, for example, let's say you want to do the top A's, find a cutoff for the top A's. Where should it be? Should it be 90? Should it be 87? Where is the point to where there will be 10%? Where is that? So we want the chance that X is greater than or equal to some number A. So A is like here, or something. And it goes from, so the area under the curve from A to all the way up to infinity, all the way out to the right tail, and whichever area that is, represented by this integral, for that density function that we use for the normal distribution. And there's your 5, and there's your 80 for your mean, and there's your 5 for your standard deviation. So we're fitting this one to the results of the test, which had mean 80 and standard deviation 5. And that integral will equal, we clean up that integral a little bit here to get to 50 there, and that has to come out to be 10% or 0.1. And our goal is to find the A or the X value on this line somewhere so that that happens. Well, it'd be nice if we could compute this integral. But with our methods, we can't do it. We cannot get a nice closed form answer like we normally do. You can get an antiderivative other ways. We're going to learn how to do one way, the series form of how to do it. But right now, we're going to do a table method in our calculator. So first thing we're going to do is get your calculator and put in the density function with the proper 80, the 2 times sigma squared here, the sigma there, standard deviation. Put that in there. Then in Y2, put in function integral with this syntax here with the commas. Now, how are you going to do that? To get the function integral, you're going to go to the math key, scroll down to the function integral, and press enter, and it's going to put that there. Then how do you get this Y1? From vars key, scroll over to yvars, then choose the function, and then pick off the list Y1, and that puts Y1 there. Then you go comma, x, 200. This part here shows you your range that you're integrating over. Now, the reason why it's 100 is because in this distribution, 100 is essentially infinity. Let's look at that curve again. Here's your curve. See, by the time you get 95 is here, 100 is so far out there, there's very little area. So we can't put infinity in there, so we're going to put 100, which is essentially infinity for this example. Now, you might not see function integral pop up when you select the math function integral. You may see this over here pop into your calculator at Y2. That's a newer version, so you might see that. Okay, so if you see that, then you put your X here, you put your 100 here, which is what you're using for infinity. You do that VARS method of getting to Y1, and you put an X in here for the DX. So you make it look like this. Okay, so either way is going to happen there in Y2. It's either going to be this way, or it's going to be this way, depending on the newness of your calculator. Then you're going to go to second table set. And this really doesn't matter because you can really start anywhere. But we're going to start it at the mean and go with delta table 5. That's not really critical though. But what is that the independent, you want to ask, set it to ask, not auto, for asking for the values. Because you want to be able to put in different values. And for the dependent, that's left on auto. So, in step number 4. Now you go to second table. And for X, you put in your guess for the top 10%. The Y2 column gives the area answer for this, no matter what syntax you have in there. Okay, so your guess is going to be here. And so on the second table, you type in your guess for the top 10%. So I started off with 90. So I went to second table, and I put in 90 and enter. And the Y2 column, not the Y1, the Y2 column that shows up in that table said that the area for 90 up to 100 was 0.0271. But we want the X value that produces 10% or 0.1. So this is too small. We need more area out there in the tail. That means we got to back up on our X value to produce more area to the right. So then I put in 87, second table, 87. And the Y2 said it was 0.0807. That's close. Then I put in 86 into the table, second table. And the Y2 column said it was 0.1150. That's too much area. So it's in between these two. So then I kept on checking in between there with one decimal place. You don't have to get more accurate than that. And when it arrived at 86.4, Y2 said it was 0.1002 area out there, close enough for us. So our cutoff for the A's, the top 10% of scores, the top 10% area, all in here. That's 10%, 0.1 area right there, is 86.4 is the cutoff right there. Just beyond one standard deviation above the mean in this distribution. Okay, so that's the method. Now the teacher wanted the middle 50% to get C's. So we'll find the X from the mean, which is 80, up to X that gives and produces 25% of the area. In other words, we want to do this. From 80 up to this X, we want that area to be 25%, because we also want 25% below 80. So we want somewhere in here, we want this area up there to be 50%. So we need 25% on one side and 25% on the other. So we're just doing one half of this and making it be 25%. So which is stated right here. So in Y2, change what's in there to be 80 up to X. And we're going to guess this X. Okay. By the way, this X right here just says we're integrating with respect to the X that's in the formula. This is the range. These. 80 up to X. Or if it gives you the integral form inside Y2, do 80 up to X. Then you hit second table again. And I guessed A3. And so the integral from 80 to A3 of our density function turned out to give out 0.2257. That's under 0.25. That's not enough. So we need to raise our guess to get a little bit bigger away from 80. So when you put in 84, it said it was 0.2881. That's too high. So then you guess decimals in between there, and it turns out that 83.4 gives you 0.2518 area. And that's close enough. This means by symmetry of the curve, because it's equal above and below, that if you subtract that difference, so there's 25% of the data from 80 to 83.4, that's a 3.4 difference. If we go below 80, that'll also be 25%. So that goes down to 76.6, and that's the lower cutoff. So in other words, around 80, there was 25% from 80 up to 83.4, and then subtracting that 3.4 off of 80 to go down to here, there was another 25% symmetrically in here to make the whole thing 50%, and that cutoff down there was 76.6. So now we know the cutoffs for the C's. Okay, this means that by forcing it, the 83 to the 86 must be your B range. Okay, so that's covered. Now the teacher wants the bottom 10% to receive F's. We already know by symmetry that the bottom 10% will be, remember, the top 10% went up to 86.4. So that difference is 6.4. So from the mean up to the cutoff for the A's was a 6.4 difference. So if you go down from 80, that same amount, that's 73.6. So that's going to be your cutoffs for the F's. Then I went to Y2 and verify that. I changed it to go from 60 up to X. Now 60 is essentially negative infinity, because that's 4 standard deviations below the mean, where there's hardly any area beyond there. So 60 is acting like negative infinity, and then we're going up to X, and we want that to turn out to be 10% down there. Okay, so we check that in to the calculator. We put the 73.6, guess that in second table, and the Y2 indeed says 0.10024, close enough. That's 10% verified. So then here is the entire story. Here's your A range of 86.4 and above. That's 10% of the area up there. That's all this. Then your C range was between 76.6 and 83.4. mean that 50% was in here, because the teacher wanted to give the middle 50% a C, so all this area was 50%. The B range was then forced between